that is possible in divine life management. And second thing is education. You know that education, now the present education is a burden. I have given lot of lectures on education. Education has no realization and relishing. Education should have two qualities. The first quality is one should rejoice the education. Second thing, he should realize what he is being educated with. Nobody is realizing what they are doing and nobody is relishing at all. It is an unwanted burden. It is a curse. It is a punishment. Except for the graduation certificate as well as the connecting opportunities, abroad settlement, promotion, transfer, etc. The real education, direct connectivity with education is a bitter juice. Nobody enjoys that. Education is neither relishable nor realizable by the modern community. And career option, everybody, see, there is a rule known as pseudo-projection. What is pseudo-projection? I told you in an education seminar, everybody is selecting their career on the basis of limitation, imitation, coercion and other various factors. What is limitation model? I know only this faculty, so I want to be educated in that. That is limitation. Imitation, everybody is doing that, mass imitation. Everybody is doing IT, so I have to do IT. So this is imitation model. Competition model, if he can join and study, why can't I? So I am also doing that. That is competition model. Coercion, I wanted to study, I could not. So you study this. My son should study this. I am studying this, so you should study that. So either failure or success of the parent, both of them are harmful by means of coercion to their generations. So these limitation, imitation, competition and coercion models are ruling the present education system. There is no desirability. And career also, there is pseudo projection. What is pseudo projection? There may be one bus driver, or there may be one, for example, there may be one washerman. He must have become the chief minister or a very great media icon, or he must be a very big person of celebrity, or he may be a person of illustrious nature in the society. And without understanding the methodologies and suitabilities to that exclusive model, the pseudo projection instigates the temptation in a lot of people to fall into the pit. For example, we are seeing only one success model. If in cinema somebody succeeds, in media, music or anything else, if somebody succeeds, we are seeing only one person who has succeeded. We are not seeing thousands of people who have been totally put into turmoil, the thousands of people who are struggling day by day. These things we are not projected in our mission. So, this pseudo projection of visualizing only few people, very infinitesimally negligible proportion of the society who are in the success rate. I am not telling these things to extinguish or to discourage the encouragement of the youngsters or the emerging society. Everything should be with proper planning and direction. That's what I want. It is not that to say that everybody with resources only can climb and ascend into the throne of success. I am not going to just generalize it or to make it exclusive to few people. It is possible for all. Provided one should have a strong base. One should, if somebody is to be lifted from the well, the person who is lifting must be strong in the base outside. Likewise, each and everybody tempting or trying for something else, they should have a strong base. Somebody, they can do these things. So it is not a pseudo projection in the society. This is known as carrying. Apart from which, now there is lot of friction in the relations of the families. Now the problem is, that's what I told in one seminar, disaster seminar. It is known as I told that there is water crisis, there is oxygen crisis, there is energy crisis and also love crisis. Love crisis and relative disaster. We don't have relations at all. If we have, they are as disastrous as earthquakes. So this thing, relation, there is a problem in the society. Number one, in each and every family, the parents, either they are over rigid, they are exorbitantly rigid, are totally ignorant and negligent about the issues. And second thing, there is a generation gap. And the children must also be taught about the past and values so that they will, for example, this is G1, generation 1. This is generation 2. There is no possibility for this or this. We cannot expect all people to be so orthodox and anti-diluvian. We cannot expect all people to be ultra-modern. And this type of generation gap is to be removed only by understanding, not by changing their mannerisms and other things. So removing generation gap does not mean that the younger generation should have tuft and dhoti like this, or the ultra-modern t-shirt should be worn by our ancestors. It is not something connected with our dress. It is not connected with the attire, but our attitude and aptitude. So that must be a proper way. G1, G2, G2, G1 merge is very impossible. That can rarely occur. But there is a model suggested by great scholars. That is a comfortable status or stopgap between this G1 and G2 here. These older generation, they must understand what is contemporary status and what are the things that are required for the modern society and the trend they have to analyze. If they analyze to a proper limit, they will come here. And if these people, they can understand what are the values of our past and why they are also striving so. So a bilateral discussion and transformation reasonably and rationally that happens between these two generations will create both of them to halt in a salubrious midpoint, which will make this generation gap totally lubricated, resulting in proper way for development for both of the people. This is the real thing. So coming into relations, I told you in seminar, and it was very humorously felt by everybody, but it is also humorous in nature because it is truth. One, there are only four relations. Your parents, brothers and sisters, wife and children, close relations. You disown your parents. Dispute with your brothers and sisters. Four D's. Divorce your wife. You disown or distant from your children, or as a boomerang effect, you are disowned by your children. This is a modern psychic society. So, disown your parents, dispute with your brothers and sisters, divorce your wife, and you will be automatically disowned by your children, or you can maintain distance. Is this the society we wanted? It is not a boomerang effect. In all things, you see, crushing the heads of agriculture, the founding industry we developed, mechanical industry. Crushing mechanical industry and that work IT industry flourished. And what happened? It is known as, that's what I told you in seminar, it is the strength of the weak. You must not think that everybody is weak. They cannot directly attack you. The curse, the crave, the cry and call of innumerable people who are excruciatedly suffering due to hunger and insufficiency that will reflect in the form of global inflation, superinflation, recession, everything, etc. It is nothing but the boomerang effect of whatever we have done. So either in health, wealth, or in relations, whatever we do, whatever we have done, knowingly or unknowingly, this birth or previous birth, whatever we get is boomerang effect. By understanding this, one can get a clear, one can get a clear vision about what we are going to do and what we have done already. So this impact analysis and self-subjection as well as self-rectification is possible only by understanding the rule of causality. This clarity is given only by our land. That is why it is known as Indian wisdom. Wisdom means it is only Indian. When we can say about Eastern knowledge, Eastern thinking, everything we can say. And whenever you say wisdom, wisdom is complete and completion is divine. And divine is something which is meant only for realization. Realization is only by penance. Penance is only through scriptures and scriptures.